Hello, everybody. My name is Alan Cowles. I'm a principal product manager at Red Hat, and I'd like to introduce you to our demonstration today, where we are going to do the prerequisites on a Red Hat OpenShift service on AWS or ROSA cluster to enable it to host OpenShift virtualization machines, which is a feature that we are going to begin supporting with the release of OpenShift 4.14. In order to support virtual machines, a ROSA cluster must have bare metal nodes. Now, a default deployment of ROSA, I'm going to go ahead and click over to the EC2 console right here. We are running all virtual nodes in EC2. So in order to add bare metal nodes, we are going to go to our hybrid cloud console, and we're going to take a look at our machine pools. And we are going to create a new machine pool. And in this case, I'm going to call this worker metal. And we're going to select that metal type. There's a lot of different types of nodes to pick from here, but we're going to scroll down here until we see the M5 metal node, 96V CPU, 384 gigs of RAM. And we are also going to enable auto scaling. I want a minimum of two of those nodes in my cluster, and to cut down on costs, let's go ahead and right now set the maximum for the pool to 30. And we're going to create that machine pool. We are also going to enable cluster auto scaling. This just makes it easy so that the machine pool goes ahead and creates those instances in AWS for us. Now, what we're going to see here in EC2, and we'll refresh this screen here, and we can actually see that we have our metal 5 nodes. One has already passed its initial checks. The other one is currently initializing. So if we go over to our OpenShift console, we can actually check on these nodes here. Notice they don't show up as nodes yet. Right now, we still see just our original control planes, workers, and infra workers in the virtual types. They actually show up as machines, and it shows that two of them are currently provisioned. They can take upwards of 30 minutes to 45 minutes to actually provision and be introduced to the cluster as a node. So this is a process to be patient with along the way. While that's happening, though, I'm going to go ahead and prepare our environment for running OpenShift virtualization machines by installing the OpenShift virtualization operator. So I'm going to click on Operator Hub and take a look at OpenShift virtualization. And you can see the latest version currently is 4.13.4. But we're going to go ahead and install that. And this is a very simple install for the deployment we're doing. I'm going to go with the stable version, have it create the namespace OpenShift CNV for us, and just click on install. The operator install will take just a few moments here. Once the OpenShift virtualization operator is complete, we have to create the actual deployment of OpenShift virtualization by clicking on Create Hyperconverged. Now, there are a couple of options we can do here. Again, we're going to take the most simple one and just go with the default options. We'll get it so that it can go ahead and begin its installation progress. And we will get status updates under that column as the operator finishes its install. You can see that as The operator progresses through its install process. We get notified that there is now a web console update. We can choose to refresh that by clicking on this link. And we are now given a virtualization menu to the left over here. This gives us the ability to take a look at the virtualization features that are available, the catalog of machines that we can deploy, templates if we decide to import any, and then what bootable volumes and data sources we have available. Thank you very much for watching this demonstration of configuring the prerequisites for OpenShift virtualization on the Red Hat OpenShift service on AWS or ROSA. Please join me for future demonstrations where I will talk about deploying virtual machines in this environment, as well as importing virtual machines from existing hypervisors into this environment.